talking here!
Right. Well, this morning, the body of a young woman was found.
So what are you saying?
I'm saying we might have banged up the wrong bloke. And don't get me wrong, Terence Finn was a scrotum. I don't give a toss about him. But if we did get it wrong, I want this man caught before he kills again. This is my city, and it will be a safe place for my wife and my mum to walk around in. Is that understood?
Yes, good.
Right, find out who the dead woman was, find out who killed her. Do it now. Hold up, hold up. Do it tomorrow morning, first thing. Beer o'clock, gentlemen.
There will be no further compromise.
Welcome to another edition of
Utter Pants
Little Breakfast Radio.
Rubbish.
Well, we're back. We haven't been recording for, well, since November. And to be honest, as of right now, the New Year's show still hasn't gone out.
Oh, you lazy so-and-so.
Well, because I didn't know when we were going to be recording, so no, I thought I'll just hang on and put that out at Easter.
Yeah. China's New Year.
No, yeah, exactly.
That's too late for that as well.
Yeah, we missed that one. Oh, fucking hell. Anyway, my name is David Ingram, and each and every week I'm joined by
Dr. Diamond.
Ho?
And Bob Thunderer.
I'm Gabe.
And we're here to bring you down and get you through this rubbish.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
Yes, indeed. We're back with the rubbish, and the exterminate button is primed. And we've got a bunch of stuff that's been sent through by various promotional entities on the interwebs. Can't remember who, but fuck it. So, before we get on with that, I just want to say, there's not going to be as much music on this show. I decided to keep it short, mainly because I couldn't remember how to do it. Honestly, I just could not fucking remember how much time we were supposed to allocate for the music. It had been that long.
Ask.
And I've also tidied up in my iTunes library, so I didn't have any templates from previous shows.
Oh.
So, yeah, silly bugger. But there we are. Well, we've got beer, we've got some music.
And it could be the start of something completely new.
It could
even,
be.
Maybe even better, if it's possible. It. Yeah.
No. All righty, we'll get on with the music.
Wishful thinking.
Yes. Remember that it's a democracy, and it's we have to have at least two votes to blow something up, because there's three of us. It's the majority.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Just so that you know, except there's one track you can't blow up because it's a mate of mine.
Right. You bastard.
But anyway, first up is a band from Finland, a country I quite like to be, for their Scandinavian credit cards. It's a Monty Python.
We know.
But the band are called Revulsion, and it's the from the album self-titled. I'm sure it's called Revulsion.
Probably, yeah.
But not actually called self-titled. But the song is called Pyre, P-Y-R-E. And I'm going to have to get reading glasses for the next bit. Well, for the next time, but because I'm struggling to see what I'm fucking reading here. Anyway, it's 3 minutes and what's that? Ampersand. No, it's 3 minutes and 23. That's right. I definitely need reading glasses. But here's Revulsion from Finland. I don't know why I keep saying Finland. I just like saying Finland.
Finland, a place I want to be.
Your mountain so lofty, your treetop so tall. Finland has it all. All right, Revulsion, sorry.
Get on with it.
I don't care. Finland. Yeah.
I'll just say we're off to a powerful start on this episode.
Oh yeah.
It's not bad.
No,
it's not good, but it's not bad.
My first song on this show, it's all right.
Yeah, absolutely.
Get something in the mood.
Okay, I take it back. It is good. It was just there was a lot of the blast beat going on. Yeah. This is much better, this beat. Oh, they've spoiled it again now.
Most of it is good. There's something about the snare drum.
It sounds like it's been tuned by a plumber.
Or Lars Ulrich.
Yeah. Lars Ulrich, the famous Finnish plumber.
Nice change.
I said it wasn't good, but I take it back totally. Yeah. That was damn fine.
The beginning was a little bit sketchy, but
I agree. It was a bit sketchy. Oh God, these bloody reading glasses. you're right. A bit sketchy. What do you think, Ken?
Yeah, I mean the thing with the drum tumor off at the beginning, but overall pretty good. Are we rating these?
Yes, we can rate them. I'd give that. I'll give it a 4.
Oh gosh!
Actually, I'd say 4-, but no, 4. Just the 4 because
4. Yeah, sounds about right. Yeah,
because I mean that bit at the beginning. Okay, maybe a 3+4. No, I've said 4, so it'll be 4. Yeah. I'm not going to change my mind. So no, 4 from me.
I'll yeah, 4 from me as well. Yeah,
3+. I think. Yeah.
So in total, say 4-.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, we're not going to write this down. We'll just have to remember. There's not that many songs to remember, but we'll be all right.
So, it's early days, so we're not drunk yet, so we'll be okay.
Yeah, I've got pen and paper just in case.
Oh, Jessica Christ.
Yeah, and I've got my reading glasses on, and they're no good at the moment because my dog must have licked them. thanks, Bella. So, okay, I'll have to clean them afterwards. So never mind.
That's my dog.
Have you guys got any news you want to talk about before we move on? Because, like I said, not as many songs, so we've got time for a bit more chat. Because we haven't been together. Like I said, it was November, wasn't it?
When
we
it's been ages.
Yeah, it was November the last time we recorded. Yeah. And, we've sort of been unable to get together because we had a new restrictions put in place.
Yeah.
And but now they've been lessened, so...
Yeah, to be honest, I don't give a shit.
Yeah, we know from the...
I'm so fed up with it, man. Yeah. It's really... worth living this way.
I'm good. I mean, I get up in the morning, sit in my comfy chair with my laptop, and then code the day away. I mean,
I actually go into work. I can't work remotely, so I go in and do it. And it's the same with the researchers. They can't work remotely. They can do work from home when they need to, but when they have to do experiments, they have to come in. Yeah. So there's not as many people.
I've got lots of things to do. But just I'm getting kind of bored because I don't see any people. Like it.
I understand.
It's all almost to the day. A year ago since I saw my last gig.
Oh, boo-hoo!
Yeah. Oh, yeah, the
Roaster 2 in Sweden. Yeah, that was like, ugh! Yeah. That was on the 15th, if I remember, of March last year, man.
Yeah.
Normally, I go to a gig at least once a month. Yeah. Like, I'm really craving some live music and friends and people and beers and stuff like that. And it was like, it's getting to me.
My last gig was actually the one I played, which was December 19th, 2019.
You can shut up as well.
For me as well, with the lockdown and the quarantine, I hardly noticed it for the first 6 months, 7 months.
No, that's
because of my hip.
Yeah, I was home off work.
And then having the other one done later on, I was off work again. So to me, it's not been
the same, same with me, because the company I went work for went bust, you know, so I've got 7 months of pay for doing nothing. So like, yeah, it's excellent, but...
Stop your chuntering!
You got to stay home. You get paid for 7 months and you have to stay home because of the lockdown. I'm like,
Yeah, I can understand how frustrating that must be. Yeah. All righty. Well, we're here now and...
Yippee!
And part of Benediction, I was just thinking about the band, part of Metal Breakfast Radio's history is nepotism. And that's what's next.
Oh, okay.
It's a friend of mine's band.
So we can't blow this one up.
They're called Darlexis. No, hang on, I need my glasses because I want to do it right. Dakesis, or D-A-K-E-S-I-S. It's their Surrender Your Fears single they put out. Now, I don't know. I think Bob might like this. And Kent, you might like this. If you compare it to the previous song, it's the complete opposite of that. It's a friend of mine. Her name's Amy. She has studios and she does a lot of stuff helping people with special needs and doing music with them. And it's great. It's great. They're a cool band. So they've been going for a while, and they do a lot of big festivals in England.
But the complete opposite you just heard, so it's going to be some kind of techno pop or something like that.
Well, not that much of an
Japanese schoolgirl singing.
But I'm not going to say much about this because I've heard it and I like it.
Okay.
And it's a friend. So here's...
Let's spin it.
Dakesis? I forgot to ask her how to pronounce the band name. But anyway, the song is you know how it's spelled. The song's called Surrender Your Fears and Surrender Your Beers.
Ooh.
Great idea.
Yes.
Surrender! You are prisoners of the Daleks! Surrender or you will be exterminated!
Right. Breakfast. Wonderful.
Okay, that's suddenly very different.
I know if Donovan was here, he would be hating this immediately.
Oh, yes. But it reminds me of something, that the intro, like, the sound of the intro, it reminds me of something. I just can't figure out what
it is. I'm expecting Tyler Turunen to jump in at any minute.
Actually like this. It's not bad.
I've heard this once before, and listening to it a second time, it sounds even better. And I'm not saying that out of the whole nepotism thing.
No.
Or just because he's a friend. This is good.
I'd say that this is probably the only time that a female-fronted band like this gets played all the way through.
Yeah.
There's been others. There have been others in the past. We've got nothing. We're feminists here on Metal Breakfast Radio. We are absolute feminists.
Yeah, I think it's more like it's the keyboard thing that usually gets to you and, Donovan. Yeah.
As Donovan used to call them, gay boards.
Yeah, yeah.
But he's not on the show anymore, so we're all very politically correct these days.
Not. us playing this kind of music on the show, that opens up a lot from my record collection.
What have I done?
Yeah. I believe you have created a monster now.
You opened Pandora's box.
Yeah. Yeah.
And it seems the box was bigger on the inside.
You said she had a studio, so that she produced this herself?
I think they did, yes.
Hmm.
And by the way, the friend of mine is the bass player.
Ah.
Because there's two ladies in the band. And they also do a band called, believe it or not, I think it's all the same of the same members. So there's two guys as well. But I think in this one, they wear dresses and makeup and wigs. Because they do a band called Womanowar. And yeah, and I've heard a bit of their stuff, and yeah, it's great.
Okay,
it's great. It's a good
sounds like something that's hilarious.
Yeah, it's a good parody. Nice stuff.
You should bring some.
I'll do that for another show. Won't be this one or the next one, which we're recording in a bit. But we'll get to it.
Yeah. But I like this. But the only thing I have to say about just need a bit more bit more bombastic in the sound. Mm. Otherwise, it's
huge
great.
Huge tracts of land.
Yeah, okay. that was the what he was doing with his hands.
Yeah, exactly. the gesturing. Yeah.
But it was Dekesis and Surrender Your Fears, the 7-inch they put out, a digital 7-inch, which I think they put out sort of part of the way through the... not long after the beginning of the lockdown.
Okay, yeah.
They've also done some live streaming shows and... Amy herself does sort of lessons online.
Okay.
So, it's really good. Great people, and there's some great music there.
And good something is happening out there in the music world.
There was also, what was it, a few weeks ago, that Asphyx did a live stream.
Okay.
It was a live show, and it went really well. So, and obviously, Benediction can't do it. We've got three members in England, one here in Denmark, and one in Italy.
It's going to be a bit difficult.
It would be really difficult to do. So. And that was something that Donovan wrote and said to me, how about we do an online Metal Breakfast Radio? Do it via Zoom or Skype? And I was just saying to him, it's impossible to get the music timed so that we're all listening to the same thing at the same time.
Yeah.
And he looked into it, and he's like, it's going to be fucking hard. Yeah. So he says about once... restrictions are lifted and he can come over to Copenhagen.
Okay, good.
We'll do some shows together.
Yeah. Could be fun.
We did two episodes of Let's Start at 9, the other podcast I'm on.
Okay.
We did that online, but there's no music in that. That's just talking.
Well, it's just chat, then you can get away with it.
Yeah.
But with Metal Breakfast, nah.
Yeah.
Unless we could do a chat and then just... play a song without actually talking over it or listening to it.
Mm.
You could sort of edit it in. It could be done, but it wouldn't be as fun as being pissed and having a bit of a laugh, which is what I hope we're going to have. We're on to track number 3 now. They're called Wretched. I think that's in... not Wretched. The album is horrific. I mean, it's called Horrific. And this is the title track, which is also pretty horrific.
Horrific, yeah.
It's 4 minutes and 32.
Oh, that's horrific, mate.
That is horrific. although there is more horrifica ones coming.
Ooh.
Horrifica, is that a word? Well, fuck me, it is now.
Horrifica.
And so, Wretched, I wish I'd known where they were from. And I'm going to cross my fingers and hope... that they come from Finland. We can always hope Finland will save us. Maybe it won't, I don't know. But they'll just drink themselves to death, probably. I know, I'm attempting to do that today. All right, he's Wretched.
You'll never find a more wretched hive of scum and buggery.
So they're sort of having a meeting trying to decide what to play.
I think so, yeah. actually sounds like one of my first band's rehearsals.
Okay, get on with it.
Get the fuck on with it, guys.
Turns out it's an instrumental.
Honestly, it sounds like a rehearsal. Is that it? After all that waiting. Drummer's getting tired.
Yeah.
It's slowing down slowly.
Trying to wake himself up. I've had enough.
What was it you singing? Never learning, always burning, Albuquerque.
Yeah, yeah.
It's so what it sounded like.
He's making it up as he goes along.
He fucking is.
I think I'll drown my sorrows here.
All right. Albuquerque! Never free! You see, we're not the only ones laughing. I'm downvoting.
Yeah, this is horrific. Yeah.
It's time to go. Good fucking bye.
I love that sound.
So do I.
Yeah.
It's been so long. I think it's been a year.
Oh, yes.
Since we exterminated anything.
Something.
Yeah. And I put out a couple of shows here and there where it was just me.
Yeah.
But they're not fun for me to do. I try and make them fun. I try and, you know, bring in a few anecdotes, but I've got no one to bounce the jokes off. So it just doesn't seem to get as funny.
But you need an audience. You're not an artist.
Well, it's not so much an audience. Well, we don't have an audience. No one listens to this fucking show.
Yeah, you've got us.
Yeah, but you're not an audience. You're co-hosts.
Yeah, but this is for you. We're not like an audience. You bounce things off us.
Yeah, and I wish you'd stop that.
It's quite annoying.
You guys sound really gay. All right. Well, thanks, gent. All right, well, we'll move on. Next band, I'm definitely going to need glasses for this. Gordon Bennett, hang on. Okay, and I didn't clean them either. Fuck, covered in dog spit. Next band are called Obvurt. O-B-V-U-R-T. And the album release is called The Beginning.
That's a good thing.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's 3 minutes and 13 seconds. The song is called Osteophyte. Now, that's something to do with bones.
Yeah.
Me having osteoporosis know that very well. So, osteophyte.
Like fighting in fight?
No, P-H-Y-T-E.
Okay.
Fight. Osteophyte. I don't know. Something to do with bones.
Anyway. Yeah.
Probably collects them.
Could be.
So, anyway.
Also, in layman's terms, known as bone collector.
Yeah, maybe. I mean, osteophyte. Had I internet access, I would look it up. I could do it on my phone, but I can't be asked.
No.
I'm too busy drinking. I need a spare hand for that. So, but here's Obvurt. What a weird name. They sound black metal just by that name, Obvurt. So, we might be using the exterminator button again.
Give me a spin and let's check it out.
We'll try.
And his genitals were then dipped in extremely hot chili sauce. Double over.
also a bit stop, start, stop, start.
I don't know, I like it.
It's not black metal. Look on the bright side. This beer's fucking ace.
Bob, not a happy camper.
That was boring.
It should have ended by now, and we're only even just about halfway.
Oh, nice change. That's all right.
Yeah. Again.
I sort of like it.
It's gone all stop start again.
It's a bit long.
Yeah. Right then. Relief from Bob there. So that was Obvert from their album The Beginning, and that is also the end.
Yeah.
And the song Osteophyte. I will give that a 3 and a weak 3 at that. We actually didn't...
we forgot to rate...
My friend's band.
Yeah.
So, 5. So, there we go.
Yeah, five. So they're currently in the lead.
Yes. And Obvert, I would say a 3. Bob, you hated
it.
A 2.
Yeah. I got through.
Made it through, give it a 2.
Yeah, 3 plus. Okay. Might have gone for more, but it went on for too long.
Okay. Well, overall, it should be about a 3 minus.
Yeah.
And it doesn't matter because they're not in the lead.
But yeah. The thing about them was like the riff they do. They're like doodle-loot. It just carried on and on and on.
Exactly.
It was just boring, man. Mm-hmm. Come on. Make it more interesting.
Yeah. That bit in the middle where you said, oh, that's all right. That was a nice change.
Yeah, that was good. And then come like blah, 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 again. Come on, man.
Yes.
So, yeah, fair enough.
Yeah. So, when I said about the Dekesis being a 5, I mean, I've already got it. So
it's
friends. So a 4. So it's tied in place with Revulsion. So,
yeah.
And since this is a shorter show, a bit,
we might play
if they
both
win, I'll play both.
Fine, okay, no worries. They're good songs, both of them. So
and there's also a third song, which I'm definitely going to play on the end of the show. But more on that in just a bit. Not
ooh,
quite now.
Ooh,
we'll move on to the next
thickens
band. They're called Hell-Even.
Cock!
Hell-Even. I quite like that.
That's a bit of fun, at least.
Yeah.
Hell-Even, yeah.
Now, by the way, folks, you might hear a clicking sound. I'm getting it in my headphones.
Yeah, so do I.
You guys are as well. Yeah. I can't see that it's showing up on the recording. So, but if you don't hear it, lucky you.
Yeah.
There
it goes again.
Yeah.
That's okay.
Barmy. All right.
Could be worse.
But anyway, this band, Hell-Even, it's from their release Broken, and the song is called Into the Oceans. So basically, they're telling people to get in the sea.
Yeah, well, it works for me. I mean,
yeah.
Not this kind of weather. It's a bit too cold. Otherwise, go have a swim, you know. But
no, I mean, now I had to go out today. Normally, I'm just at home.
Yeah.
All these people out there.
Oh yeah.
go to the into the ocean.
Yeah, get in the sea.
Yeah. You off my planet.
Exactly. That's what Bella says. My dog Bella.
Yeah.
She'll sit on the window ledge and look out, and people walk past. She'll be like, "How dare you walk on my planet?" Anyway, that's just my dog. But Hell Heaven, what a great band name.
Rubbish.
We'll give them a try. 3:50. All right. And do you know that last song, Obvert? It was 3:13. It seemed 4.5 minutes long.
It did.
Let's hope Hell Heaven. Can redeem the show.
You cross our fingers.
Fingers. Sorry, I crossed something else and it's quite painful.
And she gave me head for like 2 minutes and then she goes, "Tell me when you're going to come." When I'm going to come, the only thing I can say is...
That big and bombastic, you know, for
yes.
you, but
oh yes, yeah, yeah.
I quite like that.
Yeah, that's good. That's good. Mm-hmm. So far, it's good. Yeah. Let's hope they keep it up.
But the singer doesn't spoil it. We usually do. Yep, he spoiled it.
That was more almost like Queen of the Stone Age kind of sound. Can't go wrong with that.
Tell you now, 5 points. Fucking love this.
Yeah, that's what I meant. So you said this thing has spoiled it. Like it is almost like Queen of the Stone Age.
Yeah, well, I was joking when I said about the thing has spoiled it. Yeah. This is ice.
Yeah. I hate it, but that's just me.
Uh oh. No, it's down to Kent.
No, I like it. I like it.
I think this is brilliant.
Yeah.
Maybe it's the beer talking. I'll listen to it tomorrow.
Yeah. I don't know if it's a 5, but it's a definite 4 for me so far. I would say that the vocals has a bit of Devin Townsend-like quality to it.
I can hear the band Red Fang as well as Queens of the Stone Age.
Yeah, and also a little bit like a Audio Slave kind of thing.
Soundgarden
kind of thingy.
Yeah.
I'm not into that. It's odd song now and then, fine, but it's a general now.
Oh, Bob? Will you close the door on your way home?
Yeah, well, I better get me coat first.
Yeah. By the way, your hat. I quite like your hat.
Yeah. It's a freebie.
Oh, you gave
for me? No,
oh,
for
you,
me.
You
for
gave a freebie to get it.
Fun day.
Sorry.
I like this bouncy, meaty kind of sound. That's good. Otherwise, nah.
Look at that. He likes it, but now.
Nah. Yeah, but like the sound. The sound, not the music.
The same! the sound is the music.
No, the music's also the melody and all that. That and the build-up and the chorus and all that. That's boring.
Too many notes.
God, I've missed this.
What, wasn't that an Iron Maiden song, those 2 Minute Notes? Or was it a Steve Morse kind of thing? The Purple, I can't remember.
I don't think it's Maiden.
So then it's Steve Morse that made a song called 2 Minute Notes.
Then again, it sounds like something Bruce could
it was an instrumental, so...
Ah, okay.
I think maybe it was Deep Purple, I can't remember. One of the new albums, albums. Just talking to get this music out of my ears.
So. Ah.
don't worry, I'll edit all that out. All right, that was Hell Heaven, and I fucking loved it. It's from their album Broken, and I fucking love it. And the song was called Into the Oceans. And
you fucking
what?
Love it.
I fucking loved it. Yeah. I will definitely be giving that a 5. I'm really into that sort of stuff.
Yeah,
I know these days.
I mean, that's the one thing I don't understand about you. But hey, fair enough.
Yeah. Well, I did a top 5 album thing, and only 2 of them out of the 5 were heavy.
Mm.
One of them was Celtic Frost's To Megatherion, and the other was Bolt Throwers for Victory. And the other ones, it was... you could say it was heavy, but it was heavy metal. Black Sabbath, Them Crooked Vultures, and Queens of the Stone Age.
So, you're weird.
That sort of desert rock sound I'm really getting into. Well, I've been into it for fucking years, but right now it's all I'm listening to.
Yeah.
But it's like with them Crooked Vultures, it's like, didn't you get the memo the first time around?
I missed it.
Yeah.
What happened was, when the album came out, I bought it on iTunes, left it in my iTunes library, forgot it was there for 10 years. Not even kidding. And it was there for 10 years, and it was when Desert Sessions, I was online, I was on YouTube, on the TV at home, and I saw this thing, Desert Sessions, and I was like, I haven't heard that one. I don't have that one. And I looked at it, and it said, released October 25th, and this was the beginning of October. And I thought, brilliant, not long to wait. And then I found out that it was October 25th, the year before. So I was like, yes, a fucking brand new album of Josh Homme, who I'm a big fan of.
Yeah.
Brand new stuff. So I bought it, and it was great. And something in the back of my head said, Them Crooked Vultures. And I was like, shit, I never listened to that album 10 years ago. Played it. And since they first played it, and I had it on my iPod, I have listened to that album every day for the last 3 months.
Oh, get a life, mate.
It is such a good fucking album. And I found some artwork. I was going to have a certain tattoo, and I've scrubbed that idea, and I'm having a Them Crooked Vultures one on my arm here in this space here.
I mean,
and I'm getting my friend Graeme D to align it all for me and Photoshop it so it's perfect. Thanks, Graeme.
Yeah, I mean, I'm a huge cocksucker, Deep Purple fan.
Oh, I'm going to change what you're saying there. Yeah.
But, like, I don't listen to Deep Purple every day.
Well, you can if you want.
Yeah, I mean, I could listen to Deep Purple nonstop for a couple of years with all the bootlegs and everything. Yeah, yeah. I've got here, live collections and all that. But I got a life as well.
Yeah, well, I used to do it at work because I'm there so early and there's no one else there and I have my iPod on. And I've actually got a playlist, excuse me.
Arsenal!
On my...
Arsenal.
Arsenal again. On my iPod, that's all of Queens of the Stone Age and then Crooked Vultures and Desert Sessions, everything. And it's like 300 plus songs. And I just put it on random. And
okay.
So if you're ever walking past the Cancer Society, the research center here in Copenhagen, and you can hear Desert Sessions or Queens of the Stone Age being sung terribly out of the window, that'll be me.
Well, okay, let's get back to some good
music. Let's get back to this. What's coming next? So, Hellevin, I said a 5. You said a four.
I'd have to say a 2 because...
They're in the lead.
Yeah.
Fuck it. I don't care. We can't play all of them, so I'll work it out at the end of the show. So up next is a band called Dawn Ahead.
Oh, sounds sexy.
Right, that's a weird name for a band, really, isn't it?
Dawn Ahead.
Yeah, it's from their album, Excess. In fact, it is the title track, and it's 4 minutes and 23 seconds. Well, it might not be.
No, yeah, okay.
If it's rubbish, it's rubbish, going
it could be like 30 seconds, so boom, that's
yeah,
it. Yeah,
exactly. But Dawn Ahead... It's a weird name for a band.
Yeah.
I used to know a girl called Dawn. I used to work with her. And she had a head.
Yeah.
No, she had a head.
Oh, there's one Dawn Ahead.
Yeah.
True or false? A turkey is the only other animal, other than humans, that stands on its head for pleasure.
you guys still awake? Because I'm dropping off.
I'm just listening. Okay, they ruined it. And again, what they did, that intro do the rest of the song, like, but why?
Yeah, exactly.
I like the intro, but like, nothing goes into this. It doesn't make any sense.
I think this is rubbish, so I'm giving this a downvote. It's up to you guys.
I'm not a fan, so. By all means.
I'm not impressed, no.
I think it's time to go, fellas.
Bye-bye.
Get the fuck out of it, you two Bob Joe Rags.
Oh, that was nice.
Lovely, lovely, lovely. Alrighty, now then, we're on the last song on the first half. It is quite the longest song, actually. It's 5 minutes and 16 seconds.
Ooh, that's long.
Yeah. Now, but it is the band Iniquity, so we don't have to rate this.
Oh.
So we can say that Helleven has won. But
yeah, fair enough. This is your show, so yeah, fine.
It's not my show; it's our show.
Yeah, but you know what I mean.
Yeah, I know. It's a democracy, but I'm in charge.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
I hate it just as much as you. No, I don't. So, Iniquity, Danish band, friends of mine, ours.
Yeah.
And this is from their release, Five Across the Eyes, which was out in, I fucking can't remember, either 98, 99 maybe, something like that, or 2000. But this is a re-release of the album. I've got the vinyl on order. As much as I don't want to give money to Mighty Music, I just want this on vinyl, because I really love this album, because I was hanging out with them. Originally, this album was going to be called Iniquity, Bloody Iniquity, which was my idea.
Okay.
And then the guitarist at the time said, oh, that's a Black Sabbath album, we can't call it that. It's like, well, Black Sabbath didn't call it Iniquity, Bloody Iniquity.
No.
Anyway,
but I do appreciate what he meant.
Me too. But then later on, they put out this compilation album called Iniquity, Bloody Iniquity. So I was happy in the end. It got used.
Yeah.
But they called it Five Across the Eyes, which was a line said by Al Bundy on Married with Children.
Ah, okay.
If you don't do what I say, it's five across the eyes. Something like that.
Yeah.
So. That was a terrible Al Bundy impression. Right?
Yes, I heard better.
Yeah. But anyway...
it was more like Ted Bundy.
Nice one. Thank you very much. But the song is called Cocooned. Now, the reason I'm saying that there's another song to be played at the end of the show is because back when this first came out, I was tentatively using computers and working out how to edit sound effects into songs, and this song Cocooned was the very first one that I fucked around with, adding sound effects in at certain places and blah blah blah. So what I'll do is at the very end of the show, once we've done all of our rubbish, I'll play that edited version for the audience to have a laugh at. They can see exactly the very first time I put shit together, which sounds like Metal Breakfast Radio type of humor.
Good. Yeah, okay.
So it was way back when I had my first laptop. And I wasn't using GarageBand to do it. I was actually using iMovie to do audio on. So I was rendering MP3s on a movie channel. And then I had to sort of render them into audio, because it was basically a video that was being put out with no picture.
It was rubbish.
It was rubbish. It was hard. And it took ages to render, because the laptop was it had the smallest processor ever. But it's not how big it is; it's what you do with it.
Exactly. Exactly.
You're the kind of that's why programming and coding is so hard, because users, they do the weirdest stuff with
that. Yeah, exactly. Just weird shit with the programs. Look at this GarageBand. It's supposed to be for making albums, and here's us doing rubbish.
Yeah.
All right, but here's Iniquity and Cocooned from Five Across the Eyes. This is the normal version, not the funny version that's coming at the end of the show. You guys, well, actually, when we've got to the end of this half of the show, I'll play you the other version.
Okay.
So you can have a bit of a listen to it.
Yeah.
So
we don't have to wait 6 months before you put it on air.
Exactly. Exactly. And there's something else as well on the second half that you'll enjoy as well.
Okay, good.
Something similar. Well, actually, not similar at all, but you're going to enjoy it.
Get on with it. Come
on. All right.
Impatience never fried the rice, Professor.
It didn't boil the kettle either.
That's two. How many? Let's count them through the song.
That's a bit of a cheat. That doesn't really count.
That one does.
I've lost count.
15. 16, I think.
If you take those, it's up almost like 20 now.
Fat bastard. That's 17. That was 17. There was one just before the bass bit.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
They were off to a good start, but let us down with the old weep. That's been long after nothing.
Oh, yeah.
And luckily, you know, otherwise it's been boring.
We'll be right back. many was that?
37, I guess.
I got about 36, but I did zone out. Yeah. Suddenly zoned back in, like, I'm supposed to be listening.
Yeah, but some of them are also a bit tricky, but like, whoop, they're a bit longer, but the small, short ones, like, there.
Yeah.
There was plenty of them in the beginning and the end. Like, whoop, 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 all the time.
Brilliant. Yeah. There was Iniquity there, and the song Cocooned from Five Across the Eyes, a reissue. So if you didn't get it the first time around, you can get it now. Yeah. Right, I'll let everyone know if I get it. I want the vinyl. And maybe the orange. Like, there's an orange vinyl and a white vinyl and a very special black vinyl.
Ooh!
Alrighty. So we're at the end of the first half of Metal Breakfast Radio. Let's see, on the second half. Alright, yes. Stuff that I've put on, you've put on, and the person who sent the beer money through put on. Ooh. So, looking forward to that. But not now, because we're going to get on with the commercial break.
Okay. See you on the other side.
And have a beer waiting for us, would you please?
RadioFreeSatan.com.
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 RadioFreeSatan.com. We play the tracks we want to hear.
Good evening. The next sounds you hear will be from friends. At first, they will mean nothing. But we will work together to decode them so that your friends can speak again.
From Big Finish Productions, Torchwood, Absent Friends.
Yanto, that psychic cloud is worse.
Run!
The tapes were dangerous. I had to take them away.
Dad's ghost tapes.
The next sound you hear is of loneliness and of a door opening.
Doctor?
Jack.
Wait, you are sitting in my chair.
Feet on your desk, naughty, here I am. In the heart of Torchwood, an organization dedicated to hunting me down. Well, you got me.
Big Finish, we love stories.
I'm going to save this city full of beautiful people. Look at them all out there, crawling and crying on the pavement.
That's just St. Mary Street on a Friday night.
No, right.
Well, man. It is now official.
The Shake Higgin Road Show, the finest in rockabilly, psychobilly, vintage country, swamp rock, surf rock, doo-wop, is potpourri of madness. The Shake Higgin Road Show, radio free, goddamn Satan. I'm Clint Mofesto, coming at you from the Double Cross Ranch. Booze in one hand, microphone on the other, swamp thing on the telly, and the good tunes in front of me here at the computer. The Shake Higgin Road Show, radio free, Satan.
Damn! You will excuse me, won't you? Well, thank you very much.
You are, as always, a buttery spaniel.
It'll be fantastic. I'll get to smooth your bare backside.
See, things are back to normal again.
Yeah. After that eerie music, it was, instead of a father was waiting for somebody to go and say, twat, or something. I was really hoping for that.
A buttery spaniel. Is that Clara or something?
Well, the story goes with her and Butter. When she was a pup, we'd had her for about a few weeks. And we'd eaten dinner, and we were going out. And I went back in, and I was like, where's the dog? And where's the Butter? And we could not find her. We could not find her. And she was actually behind the door eating a tray of butter, that the Danish Kærgården. It was an entire tray. And by the time we sort of grabbed her to pull her away, she'd finished it. Which was fine. You know, it's not particularly healthy. Well, we had to make sure that she... We should have put a diaper on her, really. Because that shit just went straight through her. Oh, dear. Yeah. So she's the buttery spaniel.
Oh, yes.
But anyway, yeah, welcome back to the second half of Metal Breakfast Radio. Probably not something you wanted to hear, but hey, that's what happens when you got dogs. The one thing that I wanted to talk about, which I spoke to the boys before, was why I bought myself a new amplifier, stereo amplifier, and a new turntable.
Who gives a shit?
And the reason is, I pulled out my old one, my antique one, Panasonic thing from the 1980s, and was playing some of the new vinyl that I bought. Last year, I think I bought around 80 vinyl. So I thought, I'd better start and fucking play them.
Of course.
And I was listening to these new ones. And there's one I bought was the Reader's Digest Songs of the South.
The one my parents had that one.
Yeah. It's brilliant. It's absolutely brilliant. I listen to that, and it's all this cha-cha-cha stuff going on. It's great. I turn it up loud because it annoys the neighbour upstairs. Fuck him.
Wanker.
Anyway. And I was listening to that, and there was like new death metal stuff, and I was listening to it, and I thought, oh, this is great. It's so good to have vinyl again. And then I thought, oh, I'll listen to some old stuff, Black Sabbath, Sabbath Bloody Sabbath. I know that album inside out. And I put the needle in the groove, and the music came out, and it started going, and I thought, have I got it on 45? And I look, no, it's 33. The motor in the stereo is fucked.
It's like, oh, yeah.
So I've been listening to all these brand new albums, and they're all being played too fast.
So you get to enjoy them a second time.
I'm going to. So I had to buy this new turntable.
And you've got to hate all of them.
Maybe. It was because, you know, before I was listening to some, like, Incantation, and I was like, fuck me, this song's so fast. Actually, no, it's not. So, but still, I love the Incantation. I've heard digital... It has become one of my top releases from last year. So, and also, I would suggest you guys get the new Asphyx album.
Okay.
Oh, fuck me, that's a good album.
Mm, okay.
I haven't got it myself yet. I've only heard a few songs. It's on order. So, but anyway, that's the vinyl turntable story. And
here we go.
As I was getting on the train today, I had a message come through on my phone that said, "Your turntable is available to be picked up from the kiosk." So it's like, fuck, we've got to finish up early so I can get home and get it, set it up tomorrow and blast some Songs of the South and cha-cha-cha the and fucking enjoy Sunday the afternoon away.
And annoy the neighbour.
And fuck the neighbour. Yeah, all right.
So
I've got to test it. I've got to see if the amp is compatible with it. It should be. It says it has an output of 400 watts.
How many fish heads? Five.
But I think it's 50 watts per channel or something like that. I don't know. But the thing is, with the amp itself, what it looks like he could actually have been in one of the Soviet space capsules. It's that cheap and cheerful.
Okay. Right. Sounds interesting.
What was it called? A Skynet.
Skynet, okay.
I think it was called a Skynet.
I've seen the film.
So if I'm dead tomorrow...
We know why.
We all know why, yeah. Alrighty, yeah. Now let's move on. This first band, oh good grief, I've got to do some more talking here. Sorry, folks. It's a band called Crimson Altar. It was sent in by listener Rob Turman.
He's a villain.
Now, Rob also sent us the beer money.
Yay!
He also sent money for the help pay for the production of the Stygian Dark album.
Oh, thank you.
So nice. That was really fucking nice of him.
That's very nice.
So what I've said... is that I will do a zip up an MP3 package of the entire album and let him have it for free.
Of course, yeah.
I've said I'd do it. I haven't done it yet, though, but I'm going to.
Oh, yeah.
But, no, I will do. I will do. And obviously you guys have bought your USB, so I'll throw them onto there when we've finished recording. But anyway, he was in some bands as well. One of them, Crimson Altar, and I said send it through. And I've just noticed it's 5 minutes and 54 seconds.
Ooh.
Rob, you've been listening to this show for he actually downloaded every episode.
Okay.
Every episode.
So we should know better.
So we should know better.
He has a masochistic streak, obviously.
Yeah, yeah. Because he said, oh, if you want to blow it up, you can. I heard it. It's not bad.
Okay.
It's not fucking bad. So
that's not going to be an option. So
Yeah. The song is called Break Free, which is right now what my bladder wants to do. So I'm going to sort of speed things along because it's been 6.5 minutes and we haven't played any music yet. So here's Crimson Altar, Break Free, from their release Clairvoyance. But you never saw that coming. Rush!
That's very Sabbath-like. It's a good thing, not a bad thing, but...
Yeah. Rob, the keyboards are fucking rubbish. I've seen a band photo. The vocalist has an epic beard.
Okay. Yeah, I did get it. I saw the look on your face.
At least the keyboards have stopped.
Oh yeah,
yeah. So is this a demo or is it a release?
I'm not sure.
Okay.
I know it's an old band of his. I don't think he's doing them anymore.
Okay.
He did tell me all about it in an email, but I've deleted it and I've forgotten what he said.
Yeah, okay.
But I will get the songs to you, Rob. Don't worry.
What was he called? There's a band that does these. Sounds a lot like this Black Mass or the Electric Wizard.
Yes, there you go.
Yeah. There has a bit of that sound, but it needs, as Bob would say, you know, huge.
It needs huge tracts of land.
Yeah.
I would say this is a demo.
Yeah.
I hope I'm not offending anybody, but I hope for their sake it is a demo, because production is shite.
To me, it sounds like a very high quality rehearsal where they all play at once and they record it.
Yeah.
They mic up the drums and the amps and everything. And for that, I would say that's really good.
I'd
be happy with that.
No, it's a recording for the rehearsal room. Yeah, fine. Yeah, of course.
Now he's really pissed off because this turns out it was a double album.
So, Rob, you're obviously listening to this, and we thank you for sending this through. What year was it? Kind of sounds 1963, but I don't think you're that old. So...
I say nothing. Sorry.
If you got nothing nice to say,
no.
Then don't say anything at all, because Rob sent us money for beer.
Yeah, no. Yeah. That's why I'm just trying to keep still.
Don't bite the hand that brings you beer.
Yeah. Which reminds me, I must transfer the money. He doesn't have mobile pay because he doesn't have a smartphone, but I'll have to send it to you, Kent.
I'll
do it in a bit. In fact, I'll do it while this song's on, because there's fucking ages left anyway.
Yeah, it was just five, 6 minutes.
To go.
Oh no. Well, the ideas are good, but it's so fucking boring. Sorry, I have to say it. It's so fucking boring.
If it was if they did up the production, I would say it's quite okay.
Yeah, maybe, but it just needs a pace. There's just nothing. It's like it's too long, and you fall asleep because nothing happens. It's the same tempo, same droning. Like, come on!
Shut up, you poofter.
Bob's nodded off.
Okay, stop now.
Wake up, you bastards.
Alrighty. And I've just sent you the money.
Yeah, nice. You should, the other phone number, you should get rid of that because.
Okay.
It's been 4 or 5 years since.
Okay. Yes, I will do then. All right, on. That was Crimson Altar and the song Break Free, which Bob certainly wanted to do, and which was from their release. I would say whatever it is, I don't know, but Clairvoyance, and obviously didn't see that coming, etc., etc., because I didn't know what it was. But it's sent through by Rob Terman, who sent us the money for beers and also the production.
What a nice man.
Yeah, we appreciate that, of course, yeah. And I hope he's not too mad at me, but I think it was boring. I'm sorry.
Well, just to let you know, on the next show we record, he sent another song through.
Yeah, could it be another song that's much better? I don't know.
Different band that he was in.
Okay.
So. Yeah. I put that one on because some of the songs that you sent through, Bob, were so short. I thought, I'll put this long one on this show. But we had to do it.
Yeah, of course. Nothing wrong with that. Yeah.
He was a good lad. And
it's nice to hear something new, of course. Something I haven't heard before, but didn't impress me.
Anyone else listening who wants to send us beer money, you're quite welcome to. It's my email address, lapdog1@mac.com, LAPDOG numerical 1@mac.com. That's my PayPal address. You can send as little or as much as you'd like, even if it's just 10 kroner and we'll buy 3 cheap beers. We don't care.
I don't care.
We just would enjoy getting some money from you for beers. That's all we spend it on.
Oh, yeah.
It's only on beers. And if ever we do need equipment, that's when I'll send the hat round and ask everybody. But if you want to send for beers, sure, you get a shout out and you can have a song played. So you can send a song along as well.
Yeah. Even one of your own, or something
a favourite of yours. Yeah. Actually, Rob did send a song through for us to play, and it was Ben Folds 5. It was a band called that.
I've never heard of them.
And I listened to it, and I thought, no, that's absolute rubbish.
Okay.
So we didn't play it.
Okay.
But we played Rob's, and we didn't blow it up.
That was fine, that's fine.
Yeah. All right, coming up next is a choice of yours.
Ooh.
Kent. It's...
Rubbish.
Ningen...
Ningen Izu.
Okay.
Say what?
it's a Japanese band, apparently.
Oh, okay, that makes sense.
The song is called Jigoku no Kayuen, and it's from their release, Kalden So Shite. That's what it says here. Kalden So Shite? Shito Eros.
Eros, I don't understand, yeah.
Okay, it, yeah. I apologize for butchering the Japanese, but it's 2 minutes and 56 seconds, so it's not.
But then again, get the Japanese to speak Danish. They know what it's all about then.
You get the Englishman to speak Danish is a fucking struggle, blimey. But okay, Ningen Isu. I've never heard of this band before.
Same here.
So it's, yeah, we, my mate Peter and me, we have this thing we do when we sit down and watch movies. Then afterwards, then we go on YouTube, pick a letter, then search for metal bands from countries.
Wow.
We were going for C and we found some Chinese things, and then it was right next to it. And the 8.5 minute song that I didn't send through.
Well, thankfully.
I appreciate that.
So that's it. What you do, you watch a movie and then you go on to YouTube.
Yeah, yeah. First we see something on Disney Plus, you know, like whatever. Something Marvel or something like that.
Okay. Because what I do is I'll watch something on Netflix, and then after the wife goes to bed, I'll watch porn.
Yeah. same, but different.
Same, but different, yeah.
Yeah.
But anyway, Ningen Isu, I'm looking forward to this, and it's under 3 minutes.
Ooh.
Yeah. So, nice one, Ken. Thank you very much, mate.
True or false?
Yeah.
The most popular children's author in Japan is Enid Blyton.
Love this.
Yeah, this is.
They've been together for something like 20 years.
Wow.
I mean, first when I heard that singing, I was like, this Lemmy, like kind of the same way of singing.
Yeah.
It doesn't sound like Lemmy, but there's something about it, like a Lemmy like. You know, even the music is like Mozart-ish.
Yeah, that's right.
It's funny because the guy is singing. He's also the guitar player. He has these round glasses, gray hair and gray beard, sort of thing, and he's dressed like a samurai. So he looks a bit like a sort of bookish professor.
Okay.
That's all on the verge of losing it.
It's very Iron Maiden, isn't it?
Yeah.
But this is absolutely top notch. I love it. Awesome.
That was excellent. That really was. All right, folks, that was Baby Metal. Sorry, no, that was Ningen Isu. And you know what? I want to hear lots more of Baby Metal.
Same here.
And that as well.
This is awesome, this.
Yeah, that was excellent. Really, really was. Absolutely loved it. Cool. I'm not going to say all the Japanese names again, because then I'm going to have to put my glasses on to actually read it, and they're still covered in dog spit. So, yeah. But I need to hear more, and I mean, I need to own some of that.
I need to buy
some. That was really, really good. Thank you very much.
They are on iTunes.
They're on iTunes. Excellent. Excellent. Thank you, sir.
With the English titles, so we...
Okay, you can find out what they're... But, I mean, they sing in Japanese.
They sing in Japanese.
Oh, thank God for that.
But it's not it's not
by
written...
By God, I mean me.
It's not written with, you know, kanji letters.
Okay, okay.
Because that was the first thing I found. Holy fuck, how am I... Because I found the video and I found the English title for that one.
Okay.
And then I was... Okay, how the hell am I going to translate that into kanji to find the album?
Yeah. I'll definitely be looking them up. That was awesome stuff. Alrighty. Yeah. Up next is the choice of Roberts.
Ooh.
It's VHS.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
From their release Screaming Mad Gore, the song Never Sleep Again. 1:08. Outstanding, Bob.
You wanted some short songs, and this is awesome, this.
Brilliant. And I've just seen what's up after this. Oh, okay. I'll say no more about that because this is VHS. Now, I love this band. They're good friends of mine. I've sung on a couple of their songs as a guest vocalist. Yeah. And
you introduced me to the band. Okay. That's why. And I love it. I just love it.
Perfect. They're one of the best underground death metal bands.
Oh, yeah.
And I know they put out a post recently saying, no, we've decided to make this announcement. It's very sad, but we have to say that we're going to do a new album. I was like, yes! fucking brilliant. But I do like this band a lot. So, but Screaming Mad Gore. I don't know if I actually have that album.
Yes, you do.
Oh, I do?
Yes.
Oh, I do. Okay.
You do. Thank Unless you. You've deleted it.
Oh, no.
Okay, then you got it.
Because when I did the vocals for them, he sent me through their back catalogue in CDs, so I've got it. It'll be in my collection somewhere. I just like my collection is covered in dust.
Oh yeah, it is.
I haven't used CDs for ages. So everything's been digital until now with the whole vinyl thing.
Ooh.
And we need to get these shows finished so I can go home and pick it up.
Yeah, yeah. Get on with it.
So VHS and Never Sleep Again.
True or false? Norman Lamont makes a kind of quacking sound in his sleep.
Yeah, that was great.
Yeah, short, sweet, to the point.
Yeah.
Did what it's supposed to do.
Yes. Oh, yeah.
Excellent.
Really, really, really weird thing, you know, to just take something out of a horror movie.
a small part of the film. Because I could hear they were singing, "You've got the body, I've got the brains," or something like that, or "I've got the body."
Yeah,
and that's from Nightmare on Elm Street. That's like a line.
Yeah, one, two, Freddy's coming for you.
Yeah, Fred, yeah, yeah.
So get a crucifix and
that's it.
And that's why you never come to sleep again.
That was excellent. Thank you, Bob. I enjoyed that one.
Yeah, so did I.
And now I'm going to get right into this because I've been excited about this one.
I say
it's something. It's a band called Desert Mouth. Now, on bass is a guy called Thomas Gnist. You might know him.
Mm-hmm.
Drums is Alan
Tibaya, yes.
Yeah, Tibaya, yeah. On guitar is Mass Horlew.
Oh, yes.
From Iniquity.
From Iniquity,
and
yes.
Currently in Unagang.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
On vocals is me.
Ooh.
This was recorded after I'd left Benediction and I before I joined Bolt Thrower. It was in the interim.
Ah.
It has never been played outside of the cassettes that we had when we first got it. And I lost the cassette years ago. But about 2 weeks ago, Alan T-Buyer, he wrote and said, I found this DAT tape. I think it might be the Desert Mouth Sessions.
Oh, good.
So he had it transferred to digital, and here it is.
Oh, looking forward to this.
This is the first time. Now, the thing is, my vocals, you can hear that if you listen to the album Grind Bastard, the last album I did with Benediction, the vocals are very similar. My vocals have actually gotten deeper over the years. This is, I don't know, I sound like a
puff.
A girl. To put no finer point on it. You can hear, I mean, this is sort of demo. You know, we were talking about the other band, Rob's band, with the demo version. That's why I was saying this is sort of a demo-y thing.
Well, let's give it a spin. I'm looking forward to it now. Yeah.
So, Desert Mouth. This has never been played in 23 years. No one's ever heard this except the band. For 23 years, this is a first,
ooh,
an absolute first. And I better get this show out as quickly as possible.
Exactly.
Because we've now got it. And Alan's saying, what should we do with it? Shall we release it? I don't want people to pay for this. But here's Desert Mouth. It's the song Desert Mouth from the demo, Desert Mouth. Yeah. And Desert Mouth means when you've got a hangover.
Yeah,
mouth's like a desert.
Yeah,
that was me and Mass got that idea.
Of course.
Because of all the beers we used to drink together. And I used to fall asleep on his couch. And my wife would come around and bang on the door and wake me up. And she'd be like, "What the fuck? Why didn't you come home?" And I was like, I was pissed. Anyway, here's Desert Mouth.
Full of life and possibly alcohol.
A lot better than I expected.
Yeah, yeah. This sounds great.
Yeah, it's good.
You flash in the desert mouth, a liquid living hell. Surround yourself in broken glass, it's only in the cell.
Drink!
Struggle with the beating, demon drink to rage.
That's my black metal name, Alcoholicorst.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Well, I'm glad someone enjoyed it.
I wanted.
Yeah. Yeah, man, it's awesome.
Well, you guys are the first two to hear it in 23 years, besides the band and the guy that mixed it. Rasmus, long grey hair.
Oh, yeah, Rasmus. Yeah, Rasmus Schmidt. Yeah.
Not Rasmus who plays in Ill Disposed.
No.
But the other Rasmus.
Yeah.
There's so many Rasmuses. Rasmus I. Isn't that how you say it?
Yeah.
Anyway, that was Desert Mouth, and the song Desert Mouth from the demo called Desert Mouth, that me, Mass, and Alan, we got together and we said, like, wow, we'll do this band, you know, a bit of fun. And it was in between me leaving Benediction and then being asked to join Bolt Thrower. And I actually played that, saying that you're the first, but no, it was Gavin, the guitarist from Bolt Thrower. And I played him one song, not that one, it was a different one. And Gavin's response was, well, you're not going to do that again, are you? I was like, thanks, Gav. Thanks. So, but that's Gavin for you. Gavin, he's brutally honest like that. So I don't fault him. But anyway, everyone's finally heard it. I say everyone. You guys have heard it. We're listening to the show. So I'm quite chuffed that I got to get digital versions. And there will be more.
Oh, yeah. Yay.
It was a four-track demo.
The other three is as good as this. You want to win a mate?
I can't remember. Anyway, we'll move on because I need a Waz. It is Creator, sent in by Kent, who's wearing a Creator t-shirt.
Yes.
Ooh! It's 4 minutes and 45 seconds.
Ooh, pushing it.
But it is Creator.
Yes.
It's from their single, 666 World Divided. Obviously, the title track, 666 World Divided. I don't know if... Is 666 actually part of the title?
Yeah, it is.
Okay,
it is.
All right. Why is the world divided by 666? I don't know.
Yeah.
Weird Germans.
Yeah. Yeah, well, that's...
I met Miller years ago. I was still in Benediction at the time. Well, I'm still in Benediction now. This was the first time I was in them. I can't remember the year, but 96 maybe, playing in Essen. And where we were playing, there's actually a rehearsal studio underneath the building. And he was there, and he came up to the bar afterwards. And I went over and talked with him. Had a good chat, and I was saying, like, you know, you've really helped influence me and the rest of the band. And he was like, wow, thanks, and shook hands and drank beers and blah, blah. And then years later, I'm doing Metal Breakfast Radio with Donovan. I don't know if you guys know this story, but Miller went over to California, and Donovan took him out and said, like, oh, let's go surfing. And he nearly drowned Miller.
No!
He had to pull him out, sort of, you know, that... In the Tom and Jerry cartoons, where you're pushing and the water's spurting out. He was doing that to Miller. And then they had to take him to hospital and get him checked out. And Miller was like, well, thanks for that. Bye. And just left Donovan. Because Donovan tried to kill him.
Right. Yeah, well, a good thing he didn't.
Well, a very good thing, yeah.
I'd been very upset.
All righty. So, Creator and 666... World divided.
I was drowning in boobies.
Sorry, we were just smelling my beer, which is not a euphemism. We were literally smelling my beer. It's a Lottrup unfiltered IPA. Fresh and fruity.
Smelled like piss.
It smelled really hoppy.
That's horrible.
I love that. I better drink that carefully. It nearly orgasmed on me. Fucking delicious. 5.5% as well. The weakness all blood upon your sword. Through these eyes. I've seen the front of the law. All my life. Creator. I'm not into this much. I prefer their older stuff. Pleasure to Kill. Endless Pain. The third album, I can't remember what it's called, and that's where I sort of lost track of them.
They
got a bit too...
Then they went off into sort of experimental, where they did bit of grunge, bit in industrial goth and things. Yeah. And then they sort of settled into this.
And I don't like this either.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
It's a long way from what they started out with.
Yeah, definitely.
I get that. I remember them back in the Toxic craze and things like that. I didn't know there was a video for that.
Oh, okay.
I have been Wikipediaing.
He's bollocks.
Yeah, it's yeah. But you asked for some recent tracks from 2000.
Yeah, well, I regret that now, don't I?
Yeah, 2020 and 21, and that's one of the new things that
okay, fair enough then. Fair enough.
There's supposed to be a new album, but we're still waiting for that one. They did a live one and a greatest hits sort of thing.
Okay.
I think it's okay.
Ah, okay. But just going to say whether we lost you or
no. I'm just enjoying it, you know. It's okay. Good stuff. I even like the bit Dave hates, so.
Alrighty. Oh, I better put my phone down then. I'm actually looking up the kiosk. Parcel to find out what time it closes. Because I've just looked at the time, I was like, oh, we've got another show to do as well.
Yeah, we may not get to do that other show.
Sorry, guys.
I see the native has gone restless.
I'll finish looking in a minute. But that was Creator and 666 World Divided. And I think we are divided in the room.
Oh, yes.
I didn't like that. I thought it was a bit too commercial.
Commercial, like, but it's good. I like it.
And I'm also very old school when it comes to Creator. I love their first two albums and the third one as well. I quite like that. As I was saying, I kind of lost it after those three. I sort of lost my way with them.
Yeah.
I heard something and I was like, nah, it's not for me. I'll move on to something else. But, yeah, all right. You guys liked it.
Yeah.
Okay.
And I said I know nothing about Creator.
Oh, okay.
I mean, I might have heard the odd song, but I have no records. I've never listened to them. Don't know why, but for me it's like, yeah, it's good music.
Yeah, I lost, like you said, I lost my way with them until I was at Wacken in Germany. And suddenly I found out that they had made this... You know, huge pile of albums. And okay, yeah, I'll buy a few, and then sort of escalated from there.
Okay, well done.
Yeah.
It's nice when that kind of thing happens. You know, you sort of go a band that's been around for a while, and you suddenly get back into them, and it's like, ooh, they've got a huge tracks of back catalogs.
Yeah. So it's the same when you got me into Voivod.
Okay.
You guys. I mean, there was. Oh, wait a minute. Because I remember, you know, I heard one album and then I sort of forgot about them.
Yeah.
But you keep playing them on the show and then...
Yeah, that was Donovan's fault.
Oh, yeah.
Blame the American.
Yeah.
Everyone else does.
Yeah, again, I by name and I heard when your first album came out, like, oh, this is shite, and forgot all about the band.
Mm.
And then I went to see him in Sweden live and like, oh, fuck, this is awesome, you know.
Yeah,
and,
they really evolved and quite quickly.
Yeah.
From the first two albums to the third one, Killing Technology, was fucking superb.
Yeah. Yeah, I remember Kerrang called them Avoid Vod.
Yeah, they did. Them, Slayer, and there was another band, I think, that was got quite big. Bathory. They sort of slated these bands saying, like, oh, they're just jokes. I'll never do anything. Well, fuck you, Kerrang. How stupid do you feel now? You're not called Kerrang, you're called Kerrap.
Kerrap.
Kerrap. Alrighty, up next is a band called The Crumbsuckers.
Oh, yeah.
I think that was you, Bob, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Beast on My Back, 3 minutes and 5 seconds. I believe it may have been Donovan that got you into these.
Yes. Yeah, but I actually have an album by him that I bought before I met Donovan. Okay. So, but I hadn't really listened to it much. You know,
okay,
so.
Well.
So I rediscovered them. So.
Yeah, fair enough. The song is called The Connection.
Yeah.
Now, this...
That is Connection with me and Donovan.
Yeah. Now, this band, they went on to become Propane.
Yeah.
The band Propane. I've got one album of Propane's, a CD, and... Again, they put out plenty, and I need to go back and check them.
And probably out on vinyl.
Yeah, that's a point. I need to go and have a look on the website that I use and put it into my wish list. Yeah. But it's all in Danish, so the only people I can send my wish list to is you two. So you know what to get me for my birthday.
Ooh.
Which is in, like, 10 months' time. So you got plenty of time to save up.
Oh, yes.
For all the 89 albums I've got in my wish list.
Yeah. It's only 6 months of mine.
Is it?
Yeah.
How old are you?
Don't mention the war.
Okay. All right. Won't mention the war. But here's the Crumbsuckers.
Yeah.
And The Connection.
We are ready to connect.
Make connection.
Instrumentation checked. All normal.
We can proceed with the final connection.
Say you have a vinyl of theirs. Yeah. Which one is it?
Oh, can't remember now.
Is it like a photo of the band?
No. That's this one here.
Yeah.
Yeah. But it's not that one.
Then it's the other one.
Maybe it's the other one. Yeah, I can't remember now.
Okay.
But I've got one on vinyl. I know
okay.
that for sure.
Then it's the first album.
Yeah, okay.
Balls.
Kill me!
Rabbit.
Your eyes. Kill me!
That'd be worth some money.
Probably, yeah.
Quite rare now.
I haven't looked at it for a long time, so...
Actually, no, it's not worth anything. Can I have it?
Ah, well played.
Just checking on your beers. You're all right.
I'm fine.
You can have one of mine. Cost you a Crumbsuckers album.
You bastard.
We'll be right back. That was a bit of a ending, wasn't it? Alrighty, that was Crumbsuckers and The Connection from their album Beast on My Back, their second and last album as The Crumbsuckers. As I said, they went on to become Propane. Yeah. I have this memory that Bolt Thrower played a gig in Groningen in Holland, a club called Vera. I can remember it because they have this special soundproofing system where it was a room inside a room, and it was the room in the room was a floating room, and there was like a vacuum around it, and whenever you closed the doors, you could not hear that there was a gig going on behind it. It was brilliant because it was in this very populated street.
Oh, so. Yeah.
Anyway, and I have this memory that Propane were the main support on this show.
Oh, okay.
And we had our dressing room, and they played and then just disappeared to the bus. We never got to speak to them, we never got to say anything. And it was like, why not? You know, I wouldn't have minded chatting with them just to say hello and that. But apparently they're very, not sort of arrogant.
But no, but like...
They just want to keep to themselves.
Yeah.
Fair enough. Right.
Maybe it had a long wait till next gig, so hey.
Very true. It's just this memory I have. It's a long time ago, so... but there we go. Coming up next, it's the last song of the night.
Yeah. Okay.
After this, there'll be the band that won, Hell-Leaven. And also that comedy version of the Iniquity song. But before that, it's not an exclusive, because I did play on a previous show I did on my own.
Oh, bloody hell.
But it's a song by my new project, Stygian Dark.
Yay.
Yeah, so you get to hear some. It's from the release we're putting out, Gore Lords of War. It's going out on vinyl on Dock Records in Holland and CD on Old Shadows Records in Brazil. And there's also going to be a 7-inch coming out in the US on Slaughterhouse Records. So we've got all bases covered all around the world. This is the track. I can't remember what track it is. I think it's Open Side 2 on the vinyl. And I was told that the lyrics and the way that they go, someone wrote saying, they are so fucking creepy. And I don't think it's just the lyrics. I think it's the music the same time. Because most of the songs are about serial killers.
That's a bit creepy, yes.
Yeah.
That's a good subject.
Yeah. In fact, it's only the title track, Gore Lords of War, that really isn't about a serial killer. I just went through this phase of... What I was... Bob sneezing. what I went through was this phase of watching the series Hannibal.
With
Mads Mikkelsen. Yeah. I hadn't seen it before. And I was just watching him eat lots of different people. And it sort of came to me in the lyrics. It sort of came out in the lyrics about cannibalism, murder, and different things. And that's what Stygian Dark was pretty much about, besides the title track, Gore Lords of War.
Yeah, I have the Hannibal cookbook.
Oh, wow.
They made a cookbook. The woman who was in charge of the food preparation for the show made a cookbook with recipes.
Excellent.
Yeah. My manager was, at the time when I was reading it, he sent me a chat message and, you seem to talk a lot about eating people.
Excellent. See? Are you worried, Bob?
No.
Okay.
There's not much meat. Not much meat on my dish.
Okay.
So,
but you know that chair you're sitting in, it's sort of covered in marinade.
Ah, okay. So, okay, fair enough.
Yeah, all right. But it's Stygian Dark. The song is called The Oligarch, which is the name of a fictitious name of a serial killer. I just like the sound of the word, really, to be quite honest. But yeah, here we go. It's 3:29, so it's within.
Yeah.
So here it is.
Ladies and gentlemen, Freddie Mercury.
She's a killer queen, vampires and cocaine, guaranteed to waste your time.
I've hit it already.
All right, let's go. The bitch of truth hurts, but I'll hurt you more. I'll leave you feeling worse than sore. No dismal acts of pain.
for the old Tom G Warrior.
Leeches and snails, how they feed. You pleasured my offense. Flies and maggots get their turn, reducing you to last tense. I am the oligarch. Swallow you in the dark. Your offspring torn apart. They won't know where you are. Body played with death finesse. Conscience just a lank abscess. Never to escape my sin. Don't bet on it, you'll never win. I am the oligarch. Swallow you in the dark. Your offspring torn apart. They'll never know where you are.
That funny, is it?
The bitter truth hurts, but I hurt you more. I left you feeling worse than sore. Miserable end to your story arc. I am the oligarch.
Thoughts on that one?
I can appreciate what you're saying. It's a bit scary because, like, the way you think, I'm the oligarch, that's pretty scary.
Okay. Well, I don't think scary. It was disturbing.
Yeah, disturbing, yeah. But
this guy
disturbing.
Says.
I can appreciate that, you know, the way you sing that. That's like, oh, yeah.
Well, to let you in on a secret, to give the vocals a slightly different dynamic and a slightly different sound, I actually sang sitting down.
Okay.
I've never done that before. I was sitting in my chair at home, over my table, over the laptop. I had a pop filter fixed to the leg of the table
okay.
coming up and in front of me. And I was holding one of those microphones that you sold me at the shop. One of the dynamic microphones.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
What are they called?
I can't remember.
Yeah, no, but those live microphones, it needs phantom power to charge them. And
condenser mics.
Yes, thank you. It was one of those.
Okay, yeah, okay.
You sold me two, and it was that one. I was holding it, so it was sort of being held in completely the wrong way, behind this pop filter. So it worked really well. The vocals came out slightly different to, for example, the Benediction album, if you listen to that. And when I do the Down Among the Dead Men and Ursina and blah, blah, I tried to do something different, basically.
Yeah, but that's good. But it sounded like different. But we still hear you as you, but there's different feel to it. And the way you sang, I'm the oligarch, there was something about that that I really liked.
I had this thing, you know, when you're reading a Marvel comic and then on the last page you turn it over and then the villain is revealed.
That's okay.
It's like, the oligarch.
Okay.
To be continued.
Yeah. Awesome. All right. Yeah. Right, well, I'm chuffed about that. Thanks, guys. Okie dokie. Well, that's the end of the show as well.
Yeah.
Oh, no. That was good. It was nice to be back. It was nice to have a good show.
Yeah.
And let's see.
And nice to see some people again.
Oh, yes.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Nice to get out and do stuff.
Yeah. Right?
And drink beer elsewhere other than home.
Yeah, exactly.
Sitting, in the chair that I just recorded this album in. Right. nice one, fellas. Have you got anything to add before we bugger off and do another show?
No. Just keep going on. More music, more music, more music.
More beer.
More beer, of course.
But obviously, if you run out, Bob, you can have one of mine. It's absolutely fine.
Yeah, no worries, no worries.
It'll cost you with crumbsuckers.
Yeah, I know. We're not going to get it.
Damn it. I shouldn't have said it was worth something.
If worth something or not, he's still not going to get it.
But I've got a small German soldier.
I don't care.
It's a rare small German soldier. A tiny figure, a little plastic model.
Yeah, I've got like 200 of them, so I don't need another one.
Scheiße.
He's building an army.
Yeah.
Oh, yes.
Quite literally building.
Yeah. He'll be invading a very tiny Poland.
it's called Poe. Yeah, that's it. Alrighty, thanks for listening in on this show. We will catch you on the next one, which we're going to record immediately, as they say in
Crew,
La Belle France.
Oh, I thought it was Crew. Anyway,
there could be Crew. You never know.
Le Crew.
Le Crew.
Alrighty, we'll catch you next time. Until then, chin chin.
Chin bye.
Toodle pip.
And a bucket of
cobblers.
And we'll see you next time. Until then, hail Satan.
Hail Satan.
Ever forward. And, well, goodbye. If I can find, fucking glasses. And they're still covered in dog spit. Fuck!
Bring me love. Bring me sunshine. In your smile. Laughter all the while. In this world where we live, there should be more happiness. So much joy you can give to each brand new bright tomorrow. Make me happy through the years. Never bring me any tears. Let your arms be as warm as the sun from up above. Bring me fun, bring me sunshine, bring me love, sweet love. Bring me fun, bring me sunshine, bring me love. Hey!
And now we touch Willy's.
It's a very low form of comedy.
You're all dead!
Aren't we cruel?
You ever seen a grown man naked?
Shut up!
Go!
This guy thing?
No!
All right.
Oh, now what?
I've seen a part of myself no man should ever see. Up your shaft.
Go to hell!
Stench.
Oh, my life is ruined. What the hell's going on?
Looks like I picked the wrong week for smoking.
Out of my way, jerk ass!
It is payback time.
Would you like a
blowjob? You nasty!
Fury! Nothing!
Here's the stupid guy, hello!
Please pay for your purchases and get out and come again!
That's queer.
What the hell was that?
Take it off! Yes! Let me be the first to take it!
A hand more fractured too.
It's really painful!
Hallelujah!
Surprise, cockbag!
The whole world got gay!
I find your lack of faith disturbing.
Aw, oh, crap!
And now, the grand finale!
This sucks.
You finished your liquid.